They want to replace Cognos with OBI. However, my business team, those who were using report for last 6 years, they were denying. So how did it come up with the solution? OBI can be used as presentation solution, can be used as data processing engine, data query engine, sorry. Right, presentation means displaying data. Data query engine means writing queries, constructing queries. So they were using Cognos and data source was RDBMS. Because of the report was pretty old, 6 year old, and the volume data grown by 500 times. The volume data grown by 500 times. Therefore, report become too slow. So we want to replace this solution. We introduce OBI query engine in between. So for the user, user will continue to see Cognos reporting. However, the processing engine has been changed with OBI. It's like you love a car and your car engine is old, but you still like it. You can replace the car engine and your car is remain same. This is solution one. These are something which cannot be documented and which you learn as a part of your real life learning. So first we replace the OBI query engine, and in the second step we replace the presentation engine as well. So this is a kind of business strategy people use. My business was on ready to replace presentation layer at one go. So first we replace the engine and showcase them the performance gain, and then we replace the presentation layer. We have a topic in our training program called third party reporting. We'll discuss about this in third party reporting, how you can replace the only the engine but reporting same. These are some features, strong features about OBI. Okay, just a quick walkthrough about this. What are the components we are going to talk about? We'll learn 10, 11G both, so that you should be knowing how to perform migration from lower version to higher version, from 10G to 11G. So RPD, I'll walk you through with 10G, and there would be one session about new features of 11G. Reporting will do complete in 11G. Therefore, you have a feeling of both the version. At last, we see the migration part. So these are the components we have. Answer dashboard. I quickly show you. So give me a minute. I'll show you how the dashboard look like. Answer look like. What's the user view for the same? I'm going to put my sample reports which shipped along with us with OBI. They designed the sample reports very intelligently so that it covers all important aspects of, you know, modeling. So when they sell their product, they use the same sample report. This use the same sample report to demonstrate the product capabilities. So naturally, it must be considered all the important aspects which we can use for our learning. Samples is the best report to start with. This is my sample report. How does it look like to the user? Answer, there are various components. Answer is designed for ad hoc users. Ad hoc users, people can drag and drop and create report, their report the way they like. So one component is answer. I'm a business user. I can drag and drop and create any kind of report ad hoc. I want to see top 10 market and their respective sales or their respective revenue. Anything I can drag and drop and quickly create. I am a business user who have ad hoc capabilities. So what I should know, how to drag and drop. The interface is designed so simple. However, underline what the query is being constructed, I don't have to worry about. OBA automatically construct the query. Not sure. I need not know about writing queries when I'm fetching the information. Okay, I wanted to show you the query process. It used underlined queries to generate the output. I'm sorry, I forgot. This is a data source is XML, not RDBMS. See, I just have written over here. My data source is XML. So for XML, create a tag. It doesn't create a SQL query. So how it is constructing the information and fetching, we don't have to worry about. It does it automatically. Because I'm using XML, therefore no SQL queries, only XML tags. If I would have been using database like Oracle, it would have constructed a SQL query. So one component is called dash answer, where business user can drag and drop and create the way they like. Another component is called dashboard. Dashboard is for a pre-built solution. Like I want to see the ranks of all the products, the top 10 products. Right? So as if I'm a CEO, naturally I don't have time to look into all. I would like to see everything in a very summary manner. If I'm more inclined, I might go to play around with this report and say, hey, I want to see top 5 products. So all this component you're seeing over here, all this interface, there's no programming required. Just drag and drop and tune the parameters. That's the beauty of OBI. Therefore, the overall implementation becomes less. The overall implementation time is less. Anything required, no programming change. Quickly implement this. Just select the parameters and process. That's it. So that's the beauty about it. So one component is called answer, ad hoc reporting, dashboard, complete reporting into one common unit, delivers and eyeballs. This for report bursting. As I said, I want the day when I log into my system, the first business day, the report should automatically mail to me or should mail to my mobile. BI publisher, we have not discussed about this. And a very simple word, BI publisher. It's designed primarily for desktop reporting. So suppose I have to send, company has to send some kind of memo or some kind of invitation, let's say. You need to send an invitation to 100,000 customers. So they are 100,000 customers naturally. I mean, so in BI publishing, we need to send. I have a database called customer database. And we have customer database for 100,000 and then we create a template. So you take the database from one piece, report it, take the template from another piece, mix them and send across to user. So you, for 100,000 user, you don't have to create the same report 100,000 times. Just create one template, connect data source, and that's it, your report will be created. Disconnect analysis. I download the report into my system and I can do offline analysis. Maybe I'm traveling in flight, or I just kept into my mobile or my laptop, and I can offline, I can do everything. Administration part, very little administration required these days, because you know they are self-tuned. Infrastructure administration required for load balancing, for adding more server. However, generic administration is minimized to great extent. The last one, Oracle, I mean MS Office plugin. We know that most of the user love to work in Excel. So rather than asking them to come to my web browser and do with whatever they like, we can give the solution to them remaining in Excel. They can continue to work in Excel and fetch all the information. It means they don't need a specialized new interface. They don't need to learn a new interface. They work on familiar Excel and they can continue to work on that. So there are various components, a brief about this. I'm stopping over here and opening this for your questions.